Good morning, friends. I hope you are all doing well. As you may already know, I will not be coming in today due to a schedule swap because of the PSSAs. So I'm making this video to sort of help explain what you're going to be doing today and to also introduce where we're headed. So first things first, I hope your reading homework went well. If you have any questions, comments, anything related to your reading last night that you wanted to talk about today, go ahead and jot that down in your notebook and we will talk about it when I get back. Next, you're going to read chapters 13 through 15, each reading about 4 pages while everybody follows along. And again, if you have any questions, comments, vocab that you want to look up, anything like that, go ahead and jot that down in your notebook as you read. So go ahead and do that, pause this video, and come back after you've read chapters 13 through 15. All right, now that you've read those chapters, we're going to talk a little bit about theme. And a theme is a general idea or message that a book tries to tell you. And a lot of times it comes up in multiple places. There are multiple examples of where a certain theme occurs in a book. So we're going to start talking about what the themes are in Hound Dog True. Go ahead and take a minute, pause this video, and just sort of brainstorm what themes or messages or ideas you think are in the book Hound Dog True. All right, so I'm sure you all had a lot of great ideas, and maybe you might have heard or thought of these themes, maybe you thought of other themes. We're going to focus on 2 for right now, and those are the themes of Hound Dog True, which that phrase comes up all the time in the book, it's in the title, which is this idea of honesty and like, I promise it's true. And the other theme we're going to look at is this theme of belonging and Maddie wanting to belong and have friends and belong to a group of friends. So those are our 2 themes that so far we have sort of seen evidence of throughout the book. And as we continue to read, we'll continue to see more evidence of those themes playing out. So your notebook assignment for today is to find 2 examples of each of these themes in the book. So you're going to pick 2 examples that demonstrate the theme of Hound Dog True and honesty, and you're going to pick 2 examples that demonstrate the theme of friendship and belonging. And in your notebooks, I want you, for each of these, you'll have 4 entries, again, 2 for each theme. I want you to describe what's happening in like the context, like what is going on, who's talking, like who's involved, write the page number and the chapter, and then just describe, write 1 or 2 sentences to describe what event is happening or what's going on in the text. And then I want you to write 1 or 2 sentences about why you thought that that specific scene or example from the book fits into whichever theme category you're talking about. So again, 1 or 2 sentences about what the scene is, and then 1 or 2 sentences about why that fits in with either theme. And after you do that with your journals, you're going to move into your character analysis project. And you're going to be looking at the girls' first sleepover. And you'll find that in chapters 11 through 14. And you're going to be doing the same thing we did on Monday with your timelines, writing a brief description of what is going on between Quincy and Maddie, what their relationship looks like, what you think is going on. And each of you will have your own role that you'll be doing. One of you will do what the girls are thinking. One of you will analyze what the girls are saying. And another one of you will analyze what they're doing. And so you'll do that in the same way that we did it Monday, just with a different example in the book. And as you're doing that, I want you to sort of think about how those themes of Hound Dog True and belonging and friendship are playing out in the relationship between Quincy and Maddie. And again, as we go along and continue to read, I want you to be thinking about these themes and how they apply to what we read. For homework today, you are going to read chapter 16. And as you'll see, there's a big event in chapter 16 that I want you to do another character analysis piece on your timeline for. And you'll see that when you get to it. And again, if you have any questions, jot them down in your notebook, and we'll talk about them in class on Friday when I come back. So hopefully this video was helpful to sort of answer any questions you might have about what you'll be doing today. If you have any, if you need extra activities to do, if you run out of time, just look at the activities extension sheet. Some of them you might not understand since we haven't gotten to those parts of the book yet, but feel free to pick something from that activity sheet. Most of it will be done in your notebook. And I hope you learned much today. I hope this video was helpful. And happy reading, friends. I will see you on Friday.